Hello there, everybody. Welcome back to the YouTube channel of JJ Prime Reviews. So today, I will be taking a look at the final Power of the Primes Terracon, which is the Power of the Primes Forger class, Terracon Hunger. And this is and my tongue has malfunctioned. I'm so sorry. Anyway, let's get down to the review table and see what the big deal is for this figure. So let's get it on, man. Let's go! And here is Hunger, fully transformed into his double-headed monster mode beast thing. Now, before we go into full detail of the figure, we must talk about the most important thing that was included in the package, which is the collector's card. So you have a nice, beautiful artwork there for Hunger himself in his beast mode. Pretty cool. You got the Prime symbol right there, Power of the Primes, Terracon Hunger, Decepticon symbol right there, Transformers Generations logo right in there. And come to the back here, he is Vector Hunger, feeds on time itself to wipe events from history. Very cool description. Anyway, so that is pretty much it for the collector's card itself. Alright, so now we are done with the card. Let's get in close here so we can take a look at the details right here. Nice beautiful head sculpts right here for the beast mode. I do quite like the head sculpt. Really nice. Now this detail right here, you can see this section on the top of his head. That's a sticker. Got nice red paint for the eyes. For some reason, these stickers don't want to peel off. You got these pink paint for the pink paint for the horns, the spikes right there, and these details are the stickers right here. Sometimes the stickers are they kind of suck because, you know, sometimes when they put the stickers, they're very crooked. That's what it is. And it got nice pink paint for more spikes right here. Pink paint right here, and pretty cool in my opinion. This didn't go all the way up. There we go. There we have that. You got his tail right in there. You can see his hands are just sticking out. So, yeah. And some more pink paint right here as well for the little legs right here, the little front legs. Yeah. You can see all the combined mode bits right here on the bottom, yeah, which is pretty cool. And the Decepticon symbols right here. Unfortunately, this Decepticon symbol sticker is a bit crooked, which kind of bugs me a little bit. Pretty cool. Hold on. Let me come back for a little bit here because there's something I have to do. Okay, I'm back. Anyway, let's talk about the articulation in this mode. So this section right here is on a hinge, so you can actually move the heads up and down, which is pretty cool, and he can definitely open and close his mouth right there, which is really, really nice. You can actually use this hinge as well to move the heads left and right. You can use this this joint right here is on the double hinge. You can actually move the neck joint around if you want to. You can use this swivel right here. You can use this joint right here. You can use this joint to move that's more for robot mode articulation, but you can use that if you want to. The front legs, they can rotate a full, they can't really rotate a full 360 because of this section right here. It gets in the way. You can move this down on this hinge if you want to, but that's more for transformation. And you can move the hind legs around on this ratchet joint, which is pretty cool. You can use this swivel. You can use this knee joint if you want to. Knee joint, because that's more for an elbow joint in robot mode. It's pretty cool. You can do that if you want to. You can actually unclip this foot right here to move this down, but that's gonna reveal the robot mode hand. And you don't want to do that in beast mode. You can actually move up his tail if you really want to. Hey, it's a thing. It's a thing you can do. And for some reason, this one loves to, I don't know why. There we go. Now that's better anyway. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the articulation in the monster mode. So now let's talk about the accessories that he comes with. Now he does come with the combined mode feet. Yay! Finally, we can talk about the combined mode feet. You can see this gap right here. You can actually put in a Prime Master or a Titan Master, or you can actually use the other accessory that he includes the Enigma of Combination. Let me bring down the camera a little bit more so you can see what it is. So yeah, pretty cool. Let me focus the camera. There we go. Nice yellow airbrushed paint on the center right there, and that's pretty much it for the paint on the Enigma of Combination. And now the Enigma of Combination, this is on a Titan Master connection, so you can actually plug this on your other Titan's Return bodies if you want to be funny about it. So you can actually use this as a head, which is pretty disturbing and pretty weird, but anyway. So you can actually plug this into the combined mode feet. You can power up the combined mode feet if you really, really want to. That's pretty cool. Pretty cool, you can do that. But there's another thing you can do with the Enigma combination, but we'll get down to that when we get into combined mode. So to store this in to store the combined mode feet in the beast mode, there are posts on the sides of these hind legs right here, so you can actually plug this in like so, and it's squeaky. A little bit squeaky when you plug it in, and there you go, just plug that in. And yeah, that looks totally ridiculous. It looks totally, totally ridiculous. But hey, it's storage if you want to store them. But anyway, so I'm just gonna take this off. Take this off right now. Eesh. Anyway, so right now, let's get down to some size comparisons. Here is Hunger compared with the Transformers Prime Beast Hunters Legion class Hunger. So you can see how they scale with one another. And finally, here is Hunger fully reunited with his Terracon teammates. Oh, the family has been reunited and it feels so good. So you have Sooner Twin, we got Blot, we got Cutthroat. His name is still disturbing anyway. So, and we got Ripper Snapper. And oh my goodness, these Terracons look so good together. I love these guys. I love these figures. Hunger is definitely my least favorite though. He's my least favorite. He's not a bad toy. He's not a bad toy per se, but it's anyway. So, but yeah, they still look great together, and yeah, I love these guys. Love these guys so much. So that's pretty much it for the alt mode comparisons. Okay, so I guess we are finished with the monster mode itself. So I think it is time to transform Hunger into his combined mode. Yes, we're going to combine mode first, and then we will move on to the robot mode to finish off with the review. So the first thing I want to do is when to flip in the heads right here, just flip them in, and there we go. So now there are two slots right here. They're meant for these two tabs to tab into. So just bring this down, just rotate this around, and just bring all this down until they tab into place. There we go, just like that. And just do the same thing on your side, just rotate this around, bring all this down until that tabs into place, just like so. If I can do it, there we go, just tab that in right there. So now I'm gonna take this section right here, just flip this out, if I can, just take this, there we go, just flip that out, and that would reveal the combined mode head. Just bring this out, just tab this into place, just clip that into place, there we go, clip it into place, there we go. So now I take his horns right here, just flip that out, and there we go. So now, I'm just straighten up these hind legs right here, and then rotate this around, make sure they're straightened out, so there we go, and just bring all this around, just bring this down, just all this around, there we go, just bring this down, and just flip this around, just like so, and there you have that. So now I take this tail right here, and just bring this up. And as you bring this up, you can see here, this spike right here will actually push this section out. So that's pretty cool. So just bring this down, bring this up, and that will push this little spike out, which is pretty cool, I will say. I do like that. Pretty nice. And now you want to take this section right here, just untab this section right here, just on a double hinge, and there is a tab. We'll tab into a slot right in there, little groove, little notch, and there is a tab. We'll tab into that slot right in there, just like so. Just tab all this in, and there we go. Now just bring this up, and that will tab into that slot right there. Just bring this up, tab it in to that slot right in there, and I think we are done with the combined mirror transformation. So, let me raise up the camera a little bit more so you can see the full effect right here. So there you have Hunger fully transformed into his combined mode. It actually looks pretty good. Yeah, I do quite like the combined mode. Really, really cool combined mode. And you can see the head sculpt right there. Really, really nice combined mode head sculpt for Abominus. Pretty cool, I will say. I love the combined mode. It looks so good, and yeah, it definitely works. It works. Oh yeah, the torso mode looks really, really well done. It's just wow, just looks so good. Looks so good. Anyway, I think this is the best looking torsos I have seen in these Prime Wars combiners. So yeah, pretty cool, I will say. Yeah. Now you can actually flip this section down, and you can see this spot right here. So that is meant for the Enigma combination. So for me, I just plug this in. There we go. Just plug that in. And I can actually close it up so you don't have to see it anymore. So that's pretty cool. I do quite like that. Really, really nice. So yeah. So that's pretty much it for the combined mode. So let us get down to the robot mode transformations. And I'll just untab all this and just bring this down. Like so, just tap this back in, just like that. Just untap this, rotate this down, and just bring this up. And then just go into that gap right there. And just untap this, bring this down, and just rotate this up. And it will just fill into that gap right in there. So just untap all this, untap all that. And now you're going to rotate these horns down, just like so. And just untap this, untap that. And just bring the tail down a little bit, and just bring this in, just like so. And I want to untap this, and just bring this down on this hinge, so you can actually have your clearance to flip out the robot mode head, which can be a bit hard to do. There we go, just flip out the robot mode head, and just tap this back into place. Tap this back into place. That tab has to go into that slot right there. There we go, there you have that. And just bring the legs down, rotate this to the forefront, there we go. And now you want to take this little spike right here, and this will just flip around just like so, fill in that gap. And now you want to take this dragon, this beast head right here, just bring this down, and just open up the jaws really wide to make up the robot mode feet. That's pretty cool. And yeah, so there you have one leg all done. The same thing on the other side, just rotate the forefront. Now I take this section right here, just flip this up, just like that. And now I'm gonna take the monster head right here, just open up the jaws really, really wide, so make up the robot mode feet. The robot mode foot, there we go. So now that we have the legs pretty much all done, let's deal with the arms right now. So just take the arms, just rotate them down, rotate them around so the elbows are oriented properly, and just bring this fist up like so, and just rotate this around the back just like so, and just bring the arms down, rotate them around, just bring this up, bring that up. Unfortunately, there is no locking point for the hands, but it is what it is. So I think we're done. Are we done? Yes, we are done. So there you have Terracon Hunger fully transformed into his robot's mode. And it's okay. It's an okay robot mode. I mean, it's not a bad looking robot mode, but it's still not a great looking robot mode either. definitely the Deluxe's win over Hunger, because it just looks okay. It's an okay robot mode. It's not a really really good looking robot mode I've seen from a Voyager figure. I mean, it's I don't know. It definitely could have been better. It definitely could have been better. The proportions are a bit weird for the arms because they're too blocky. Yeah, they're too blocky for my taste, though. Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. The best mode for me is definitely the combined mode. Yeah, and beast mode, it looks pretty good. You know, I give it in second place, but robot mode is falling in the last place, in third place, unfortunately. But anyway, so let's get closer. We're gonna take a look at that head sculpt. Nice head sculpt, I will say. It's still a very nice looking head sculpt. Nice little paint for the visor, and that's it for the paint in head sculpt. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Got some nice blues on the shoulders right there, and again, the Decepticon symbol sticker. It's crooked. Why is it crooked anyway? And this side right here has the faux Reveal the Shield logo, which is really really nice. But I mean, it has some nice molded details all around, but it's not great, you know. There's some nice white paint on the sides right here. But yeah, it's not a great looking robot mode. Not the best robot mode I've seen from these figures, but eh, it is what it is. But still, I wanted to get in so that I can have an Abominus in my collection, so yeah. Okay, so articulation-wise, the head is on a ball joint, can rotate a full 360, can look down a little bit, can look up a little bit. The shoulders, they can do a full 360 on this ratchet joint. They can move in and out on this ratchet joint. They do have a bicep swivel. There is an elbow joint. If you unlock the elbows, you can actually bend the elbows at a 90 degrees bend. No wrist swivel, unfortunately, but you can use this hinge to disconnect the hands right there if you want to. No waist swivel, unfortunately, I mean, due to the way he transforms, so yeah. The legs can move up that far, can move back only that far, and he can pretty much do the full splits. He does have a thigh swivel, he does have a double jointed knee, which is pretty nice, you know, full range of movement there. The feet can move down a little bit, can look up a little bit, and there is some ankle tiltage right there, so nice that he has ankle tilt, but still the articulation is a little bit limited. It's a little bit limited in some spots, so yeah. Can he hold the combined mode feet as weapons? Technically he can. I mean, you can use this post right there. I mean, you can do that if you want to, but I guess, wait, can this fit? Can these use the effects bars? Wait, hold on. Let me try this. Hold on, I've never tried this. Wait. Nope, you can't do that. No, mm-mm, they're too big, unfortunately. But for the instructions, you're meant to plug this in on the sides of his forearms. They're a bit ridiculous. I don't know why would you do this, but hey, it's a bit ridiculous. Yeah, it's totally ridiculous. It's a thing you can do. So for me, I'm just gonna leave this off to the side and, you know, have it ready for combination into Abominus. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave this off to the side anyway. So let's get down to some size comparisons. Here is Hunger compared with his Transformers Prime Beast Hunter's counterpart, so you can see how they scale with one another. Of course, this is the Legion class figure, so duh, it's definitely smaller than the Voyager. Anyway, let's move on to the final set of size comparisons for today. And speaking of which, here is Hunger compared with his other Terracon buddies, and they have been fully reunited. Yay! I mean, they look really good together, I will say. They really look good together. For me, the Deluxes have the best looking robot modes compared to Hunger. Hunger has the worst robot mode out of all these guys. The Deluxes, they have the best looking robot modes. They have the best proportions. It's in my opinion anyway, and you know, as always, agree to disagree. So yeah, to each his own. So, but yeah, that's my opinion anyway. So yeah, okay. So that's pretty much it for the robot mode comparisons. Okay, so here are my final thoughts on the Transformers Power of the Primes, Voyager class, Hunger, and it's fine, you know, it's an okay figure. It is enjoyable to mess with, I will say. The transformation is nice and smooth, so therefore it's an enjoyable figure to mess with, I can give him that. The best mode out of all the modes that I've seen from Hunger is the combined mode. That's the best mode, for me anyway, that's the best mode for me. The combined mode is the best, it just looks the best to me. The monster mode, it looks better than the robot mode itself, so for me, the monster mode is definitely in second place, as I said earlier, and of course robot mode is in the last place, it's in third place. I mean, the robot mode doesn't look that bad, but it's not great either, it just, just has this weird proportions for the robot mode, it kind of kills the figure for me. I don't know. I mean, he does have some nice, like, sticker detailing, nice molding details right here and there. I will give him that. He does have some nice paint and, you know, and colors right there. And he also has some nice articulation. The articulation is pretty good on the figure, so you can actually pose him really, really nicely if you want. Articulation is a little bit limited due to the waist, you know, there's no swivel on the waist and there's no wrist swivel, unfortunately, but hey, it is what it is. So yeah, so if I were to rank Hunger from a scale of 1 to 10, I think I would just give him a 6.5 out of 10. So unfortunately, he's a bit worse than the deluxes. So yeah, it definitely could have been better in terms of the design, in terms of the proportions. So yeah, it definitely could have been better. But hey, it's still a fun toy to mess with overall. So okay, so I think that's pretty much it for today's video review. So ladies and gentlemen, if you are completely new to the channel, go ahead and click that subscribe button down below. And while you're at it, click that notification bell icon down below as well so that you know when my new videos are up and ready. And you can always check out my Power of the Primes reviews playlist for any videos you may have missed. I'll post the link to that playlist in the description down below. And I think that's pretty much it for me to say. So they have the Transformers Power of the Primes, Voyager class, Hunger, and this is JJ Prime signing off. Peace out.